Sri Lanka Festival is for us to showcase Sri Lanka. We have invited people here in Canberra as well as nearby cities to come and see Sri Lanka's culture through its art and music and also food. And this is one instance where Australians can see real taste of Sri Lankan culture. On the stage will be large number of cultural items, performances by traditional dancers, and also there will be a large number of Sri Lankan dishes, so cuisine, where you will taste genuine Sri Lankan food here. The purpose of this is to have a cross-cultural mix. At the moment, there are 172,000 Sri Lankans living in Australia, and it's still growing. And most of them are professionals, academics, talented people, and they have settled here and they have not forgotten Sri Lanka as well.
Okay, we've got a very vibrant Sri Lankan Australian community in Canberra, and together with the Sri Lankan Embassy, the Sri Lankan Festival has been a real item on the multicultural calendar every year, celebrating the fantastic, vibrant Sri Lankan culture with fantastic performances, with food and other cultural activities on display. It's an opportunity for Canberrans and those from around Australia to provide better connections to Sri Lanka. And of course, Australia has enjoyed connections over many decades since 1948, the independence of Sri Lanka through diplomatic ties, but also cultural ties through sport. Most recently, of course, through our fantastic test match here at Manuka Oval in Canberra in February of 2019.
Sri Lankan Airlines started operating in 2017 to Melbourne as a direct carrier. Now we have completed 2 years of operation to Australia. Culturally, it was very important for us to operate into Australia, because apart from the Middle East, Sri Lankans are a huge community of Sri Lankans living in Australia. My favorite place in Sri Lanka is of course Kandy, because I come from Kandy, and Kandy has been, for people who don't know, it's a little city in the hills with a lot of history and a lot of nature's beauty.